गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल. दिस इज रीना शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर बॉटनी फ्रॉम गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज सतपुली पौड़ी गढ़वाल. इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर आई विल डिस्क्राइब अबाउट जनरल आइडिया अबाउट जियोग्राफिकल इरा. द जियोलॉजिक टाइम स्केल इज अ रेफरेंस स्केल फॉर द एंटायर अर्थ्स हिस्ट्री. इट हेल्प्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द एंटायर हिस्ट्री ऑफ अर्थ इनटू वर्केबल यूनिट्स बेस्ड ऑन All the available evidences, the Earth is found to be around 4,500 million years old. In other words, the Earth is almost 4.5 billion years old since the starting point of the hot universe, which gave birth to the galaxies. The passage of time can be related to a series of events. In order to construct the history of past events, one must determine how much time elapsed between the events and how long it took for the events to occur. Time is also marked by certain characteristics or unique set of events. When we list the events in an order in which they took place, we establish a chronological sequence of all the events. The change that was considered were the emergence or coming into existence of something new, the alteration of something that was already existing, or the disappearance or loss of something widespread into a region. To answer all these questions, scientists have constantly tried and searched the clues that sequences on the planet from its origin. They studied the solar system and its evolution very meticulously. It is the change in the components of sedimentary sequences that made people to know about the duration, and that has provided the basis for the measurement of the past and time units. Everything we do has got a time frame. The lifespan is limited to some years. Time is not a just unit or feature or phenomena of the present. Was the Earth originated along with the universe or at a later stage? How long is the history of the Earth? There are several such questions which are to be answered while studying the history of the Earth. The early history of the planet is described in billion year unit of times. The late history of Earth is described in million year units of time. And finally, the recent time is described in 1,000 of year units. Several experts attempted to reconstruct the schedule of events, profound changes that happened at various stages by considering the aspects of the Earth's physical system. The geological time scale was formulated with care for universal application. The changes that occurred throughout the history of the Earth stand well in the form of distinct and contrasted features. They all have shown orderly and uniform operation of natural systems in the past. The early history of the Earth differs in character from late history. Due to this reason, there was a need to divide the units of time in terms of billions of years or millions of years. Some of the major events like mass extinctions, appearance of new species or genera of life, mountain building movements, drifting of continents, spreading of oceans floors, widespread glaciation, dominance of certain species, massive migration of life between land and water are all considered while accounting the geologic time scale. These have shown very interesting aspects and features. The geological time scale was constructed using the evidence collected from various sources like field observation, fossil records, stratigraphic correlations, radioactive dating, paleomagnetic orientations, orbital revolution pattern of the Earth, and the duration of the daily rotation of the Earth around its axis. These evidences have indicated that there were several major incidents that happened in the history of the Earth during various stages and ages. The whole historical past of the Earth from the origin of life till date are classified into eras, periods, epochs, and ages. The time scale which spreads the Earth, its geological history into divisions and subdivisions is known as the geological time scale. The time scale is very wide and cannot be mathematically shown in a small graph. This lesson highlights the importance. This topic highlights the importance and details of the geological time scale. Due to this reason, the age of the Earth is also related to the age of the solar system. From the Big Bang theory till today, the time span or time frame of the Earth's evolution is very expansive. The periods of remarkable development in the evolution of life, the stages in the evolution of continents, the stages in the evolution of ocean basins, the origin and evolution of life on Earth, and their mass and extinctions are represented in the form of geological records on the surface rocks and sediments all over the world. They clearly show the fossilized evidences of the past life and environment. While studying the physical geology and history of the planet of the Earth, it is necessary to know about the geological time scale in detail. The study of geological time scale is necessary to every student of the Earth, atmospheric, and all life sciences. The origin and evolution of the Earth took place over a period of billions of years. The evolution of life on Earth is also part of that prolonged Earth's history. It is a fact that the planet Earth has evolved as one of the planets from the common duration. Now,
first one is Precambrian era and second one is Cambrian era. The short form of millions of years is represented as MYA. The duration of Precambrian era refers to the span of time between 4,500 million year ago to 540 million year ago. It is further divided into two eras. As first one is Archean era, duration 4,500 million year ago to 2,500 million year ago, and second one is Proterozoic era, from 2,500 million year ago to 540 million year ago. These are further divided into various periods. The notable observations of Precambrian periods are first one is first appearance of life on Earth. Second one is tectonic plates were present and began moving. Third one, atmosphere become enriched in oxygen. And fourth one, dry and cold climate the warm and moist condition prevailed on the earth. This is the earliest of the all the geologic ages. It is further divided into Proterozoic era and Archean era. The age of the earth is probably about 4,500 million years. First, I will describe the Archean era. The Archean era is the oldest era of the earth between 3,960 million years ago to 2,500 million years ago. The significant observations of this period are extensive mountain building, formation of banded iron ores and greenstone belts, existence of shallow seas, and accumulation of free oxygen and origin of life, especially the prokaryotes, bacteria, and blue-green algae. And the second era is known as Proterozoic era. The Proterozoic era is the second era after Archean era. The significant observations of this period are climate was dry and cold, and environmental conditions was warm and moist, and origin of eukaryotic cells and multicellular life occurrences of earliest known fossils, including of soft-bodied marine invertebrates, origin of sponges, cnidarians and annelids. And second one, Cambrian era. Cambrian era also divided in three types. First one is Paleozoic, second one Mesozoic, and third one Cenozoic. Paleozoic era, the duration of Paleozoic era is the time of ancient life. This is the second major era of the Earth's history. It is the age of invertebrates. This era has the span over a period between 540 million years ago and 245 million years ago. Paleozoic era is further divided into six periods. As first one is Cambrian, second one Ordovician, third one Silurian, fourth Devonian, fifth one Carboniferous, and sixth one Permian. These are very important periods in the Earth's history. Each period has shown a very significant change in the planet constituents. The Cambrian period. The Cambrian period is spread between 540 to 505 million years ago. This is the period of abundant life on Earth. After the Proterozoic, the significant observations of Cambrian period are prevalence of mild climate, extensive seas, spilling over continents, shelled marine invertebrates, explosive growth of eukaryotic organisms, and different types of characteristics in living organisms represented, like swimming, floating, crawling, cleansing and growing seas animals, appearance of trilobites, brachiopods, gastropods, radiolarians, sponges, echinoderms, starfish, sea cucumbers, jellyfish, worms and water, scorpions. Existence of plants was observed only as like algae. This period is marked by the absence of land plants. There was a significant prosperity of life in the oceans than lands during this period. During this period, the continents had a soil crust and were resembling ridges. And the next one is Ordovician period and second period. The Cambrian period is followed by the Ordovician period. It has a duration between 505 million year ago to 438 million year ago. The significant observations of the Ordovician period are mild climate, adaptive radiation, shallow seas retreating from land and spreading back all plants and animals, is still restricted to water. The first vertebrates originated as jawless fishes in vertebrates dominated. In this period, like crustaceans, trilobites, graptolites, branchiopods, bryozoans, echinoderms, corals, molluscas, and cephalopods all dominated in the water masses. The first fungi originated during this period. Invasions of land by plants started. The sea levels were high during Ordovician. The first known marine transgressions occurred during this period. The southern continents were collected into a single landmass. It was named as Gondwana land. The world's major mountain building activity happened during this period. And the third one is Silurian period. The Ordovician period is followed by the Silurian period. It is spread between 438 million years ago to 408 million years ago. The significant observations of the Silurian period are the world has seen a mild climate and experienced a stable and warm temperature during this period. The continents were generally flat and flooded. The notable mountain building occurred in Europe. The rhizophyses and reef building corals were originated in this period. There was marked abundance of shell forming sea animals, dominance of sea lilies and land scorpions, and invasions of land by arthropods. In this period, the earth has found the origin of the earliest vascular plants. The modern group of algae and fungi got evolved during this period. Almost 60% of the marine species were wiped out at the base of the Silurian period. This was the first period which has shown macrofossils of extensive terrestrial biota. And the fourth period and the fourth part of Paleozoic era is also known as Devonian period. The Silurian period is followed by the Devonian period. It is spread between 408 million years ago to 360 million years ago. The significant observations of the Devonian period are violent volcanic eruptions and crustal movements, prevalent folding, mountain building activities, and drier climates. The sea were covering most of the land. This is the age of fishes, sharks, and rays. And the fifth one is Carboniferous period. The Devonian period is followed by the Carboniferous period. It is spread between 360 million years ago to 286 million years ago. The significant observations of the Carboniferous period are, it is known for its coal deposits, limestones and grit stones, and there was abundant of life on land and water. The earth has seen large primitive trees, first land vertebrates and sea invertebrates. The Carboniferous period, there was a prevalence of foraminiferous, bryozoans, brachiopods, cephalopods, blastopods, bryonites and coral. The brachiopods are the zone fossils of Carboniferous period. The lamellibranchs and winged insects were important fauna. The swamp forest with fern were existing. The lepidodendron and sigillaria were the prominent flora of the world in this period. The world's first reptiles laid eggs with cells in this period. The highest ever atmospheric oxygen level seen on Earth was in this period. And the last one is the Permian period. The Carboniferous period is followed by the last period of this era called Permian period. It is spread between 286 million year ago to 245 million year ago. The significant observations of the Permian period were worldwide continental uplift and organic movements, widespread aridity on one side and glaciation at the other side, extinctions of Paleozoic plants and invertebrates, reduction in all types of life. Almost 95% of life on the earth became extinct. The primitive reptiles dominated in place, extinctions of all trilobites, graptolites and blastoids were seen in this period. The beetles and flies got evolved. Much marine life flourished in warm shallow reefs. There was an abundance of scyphaerid, brachiopods, bivalves, foraminifers, and ammonoids. The cone-bearing gymnosperms, which is commonly known as the first true seed plants, and the first true mosses appeared in this period. The land masses united into the supercontinent like Pangaea, creating the Appalachian in this period. This period records the end of Permo-Carboniferous glaciation and the fourth era, also known as Mesozoic era. It is also known as the Age of Reptiles. The duration of Mesozoic era is the time of middle life in the history of the earth. This is the age of reptiles. This era has the span of time between 245 million years ago to 66.4 million years ago. It is further divided into three periods as Cretaceous, Jurassic and Triassic. This is the world's fascinating era with very unique life and features. First one is the Triassic period. The Triassic period is the first period of the Mesozoic era. It is spread between 245 million years ago to 208 million years ago. The significant observations of this period are continent emergent, seas were marginal in this period. The climate was arid. Occurrence of terrestrial deposition happened during this period. Formation of salt, gypsum, and red beds have been observed. The dominance of archosaurs on land as dinosaurs, ichthyosaurs, nothosaurs in oceans, and pterosaurs in the air. The appearance of primitive mammals was found in the Triassic, the domination of reptiles and cycads, reduction of marine invertebrates, first appearance of mammals and crocodiles were the unique thing. Formation of salt, gypsum and red beds have been observed. And extreme abundance of ceratic ammonites were seen. The modern corals appeared. Organic movement prevailed in some parts. The Pangaea was still in existence. Altering global climate and ocean circulation happened. The appearance of modern conifers, cycads, first turtles, lizards, mammals, and dinosaurs have been seen in this period. Flora were common on land. Second one is the Jurassic period. The world's most famous period is the Jurassic period. The dominance of dinosaur in Jurassic got registered in every mind of the human life due to global media coverage. It is spread between 208 million years ago to 44 million years ago. The significant observation of the Jurassic period are atmospheric carbon dioxide level 4 to 5 times more than the present day level. Many types of dinosaurs, sauropods, cornosaurs, and streptosaurs dominated. Great plant-eating dinosaurs were in existence. Less growth of fern and palm-like cycads, gymnosperms, also have grown so much. Oceans were with full of fish, squids, and coiled ammonites. Appearance of the first frogs, salamanders, crocodiles, flying reptiles, and birds were noticed. The formation of oil fields of North Sea happened. The first birds and lizards appeared. Mammals were common. And the last one is the Cretaceous period. The Cretaceous period is a notable period in geological history. It is spread between 144 to 66.4 million years ago. The significant observation of the Cretaceous period are, this is the last period of the age of dinosaurs. First primates, angiosperms appeared. World continent Pangaea begins. Atmospheric carbon dioxide grows to present day level. And the last era, also known as Cenozoic era, commonly known as Nutanjeevi era. The duration of Cenozoic era is the time of recent life. This is the age of mammals. This era has the span of time from 65 million years ago to the present day. It is further divided into two major eras as Quaternary era, commonly known as Age of Man, and Tertiary era, which is commonly known as Age of Mammals. The Tertiary era includes five periods like Pliocene, Miocene, Oligocene, Eocene, and Paleocene. And the Quaternary era is divided into two periods, Pleistocene and Holocene. Thank you.